First part is with velocity of center of mass, A part, and B part is with examples. So first part, how many particles are marked in the diagram? Yes, two particles. So think of a system, two particle system. It can be n particles, but for convenience, two particles. One particle is mass m1, another particle is m2. They are under effect of a mutual attraction. They are moving because of attraction of m1 with m2. Velocity of center of mass we want to find out. Condition is, there is no external force acting on the system. If there is no external force acting on the system, then force is equal to what? Mass of the system into acceleration of center of mass is equal to 0. The same chapter 3, F is equal to what? Ma. M, acceleration of center of mass means what? Ddt of velocity of center of mass is equal to 0. It means what? Velocity of center of mass is constant. For a two particle system, we have already covered what? Velocity of center of mass is what? M1 V1 plus M2 V2 divided by M1 plus M2 is a constant. Or because M1 and M2 is constant, so M1 V1 plus M2 V2 is equal to constant. Means what? Suppose M1 is 1 kg, M2 is also 1 kg. This is a photograph at t is equal to 0. After some time, what you find is both objects shift by equal distance. Again, the center of mass remains wherever. What was the velocity of the center of mass initially? 0. What is the velocity of center of mass now? 0. Velocity of center of mass remains same. 3 minutes with you to write. B part deals with examples of motion of center of mass. So different examples. Examples of motion of center of mass, or center of mass may be at rest also. Example 1, explosion of a bomb. A bomb is at rest. The center of mass, what is the velocity of the center of mass? 0. No doubt when a bomb explodes, it is number of pieces. But here, we take this bomb explodes into two equal parts. This also 1 kg, this also 1 kg. If one part moves to the right, question is, the other part will move to the left. It is true as per law of conservation of momentum also. From center of mass point of view, if it has covered distance 1 meter to the right, the other particle covers 1 meter to the left. R center of mass, as per definition, was M1 R1 plus M2 R2 divided by M1 plus M2. Competition question is, if this 1 kg mass moves to the right, the other 1 kg mass will move by what distance? That is what the question is. Answer is, there is no external force acting. Explosion of the bomb takes place because of the internal forces. So its velocity of center of mass remains constant. It is 0. If you take this point as a reference, R center of mass, yes. What is center of mass distance from this point? 0. R center of mass is 0, m1 is 1 kg, R1, this particle has moved to the right, R1. R1 is equal to what? 1i plus m2, 1 kg. R2, we don't know, divided by 1 plus 1. Yes, what you get is 1i plus R2, sorry, 0, 0, sorry. So, R2 is equal to what? Minus 1i. 3 minutes with you to note. 3 minutes to note. Example number 2 is, yes, Earth Moon system. Which of the two has more mass, Earth or Moon? Earth. So, Earth, its mass is say capital M, Moon, mass is small m. The two have some distance between the centers. This statement that Moon moves around Earth, this is Earth, is a wrong statement. Why? Because the two move around their center of mass. Suppose this is center of mass, then after some time, Moon moves to a new position, say this one, and the Earth moves to a new position. So, new position of Moon is this one. And new position of Earth is a this one. Both move around their center of mass. So the statement, this is one of the wrong statements in object equation, that it is Moon which moves around Earth with its center at coinciding with the center of Earth. False. Both Moon and Earth move about their common center of mass of the system. What is the system in this case? Yes, Earth-Moon arrangement is a system. Time with you is 2 minutes to write. Example number 3 is binary star. It is the same example, no change. Binary stars. Again, two stars. Star number 1 with mass M1. Star 1. Star number 2 with mass M2. Say, relatively small. They have center of mass at this position. They move because of mutual attraction. After some time, what you observe is mass M1 reaches to a new position. M2 will also move to a new position. Both move about, yes, center of mass. 2 minutes to write. No change. Four. Example number 4, last example. It is also explosion of the bomb, but in a projectile. It is two scenarios. Number one, that you have a bomb, you fire it at certain angle, and in case there is no explosion on its way, then it will hit at certain point. This value, say range, is 10 meters. Suppose it is this one. This is one. In case this bomb explodes, competition question. The bomb explodes at highest position in two equal parts, 1 kg, and the second part is also 1 kg. Question is, examiner gives you one condition, that in case one part falls vertically downwards, that means at what distance? 5 meters. Here is the second part. Question through. Question is, in case there is no explosion, it hits at distance 10 meter, which you term as range of projectile. Two, the bomb is fired at the highest position, it explodes into two pieces. One piece, 1 kg, falls vertically downwards. Where is the other one? Answer is, whether bomb explodes or not, the center of mass will follow the same trajectory. So, center of mass is at the same position. So, this is the center of mass. Now, one object is 1 kg, another object is also 1 kg, one object position is given. Where is the other object? If this distance is 5, the other, that's blue color, is at what distance? 5. So that both these red and blue, they have their center of mass at the same position. So, what is the distance of this blue color from origin? Yes, 5 plus 5 plus 5, 15 meters. 3 minutes with you to write.